Hi, Salma from Nordcraft here, and we just released something for all of you Supabase fans. If you go to the packages area in Nordcraft and search for Supabase Connect, that will show you the package. And if you scroll down on the package page, you'll see all of the different components available to you with their attributes configuration, the events they submit, and you can use these in your own project today. But if you want to hit the ground running a little bit quicker, we also have a new template that we released called Nordbase, which makes full use of the Supabase Connect package functionality. To use the Nordbase template in Nordcraft, you can do that when you create a new app. So go to your dashboard, click Create App, and you'll see you have the Nordbase template available to create your new app from. So let's do that. So when you open this new project, you'll see some error messages. This launches you right into the app page, which is only available if you're authenticated. So that's the error message that users will see if they're not authenticated, and it will also redirect them back to login. What we've also done for you in this template is enabled refresh tokens, so you can give users a longer authentication session whilst refreshing their auth token in the background for better security. Just a note about authentication providers. To turn providers on and off, go into your Supabase project, go to authentication, sign in and providers, and enable the ones that you want to enable. Each page in this template also comes with some little notes and instructions about how each page is set up. This is the message here in blue, and it's the component delete me. So when you're up and running, you can delete all of the components inside this template that are called delete me. If you go to the project sidebar, you'll see all of the pages available to you that have the pre-baked functionality in it. And if you want to use this template straight away, what you'll need to do is set up your project URL and anon public key for Supabase. Further down the project sidebar, you'll see these global formulas, anon key and project URL. You'll want to update these values in the template to your own project URLs and anon public keys from your Supabase project. What you'll also want to do in Supabase is when you've set up your authentication providers, make sure you add your site URL as an authentication URL. So I'm just going to grab this URL from my project. And inside Supabase, you'll want to go to authentication, URL configuration, and add a new site URL. And what you can do to account for all the different branches you'll be creating, which the name of the branch goes before the name of the project in the URL, you can just use a wildcard and add star there and press save changes. You'll also want to add two redirect URLs for your project, and that is to auth callback and reset password. So we can use that same wildcard in the URL. Copy the URL with the wildcard you used for the site URL, and at the end of that, add auth-callback, and we're going to add another one, which is /reset-password. And now I am back on my new project, the preview of the new project I just created from the Nordbase template, and I'm going to log in with GitHub. And here I am. I am in the dashboard, the protected dashboard with auth, and I have a messages area, which is demoing the real-time messages, and I have a file manager, which is demoing file upload. First, to show you how the messages work, this is a message that's happening in real time, getting saved in the database, and the message is coming back to me to display that on the page. It's using the WebSocket connection. Another message. And we can see in the database that these have been added. On the messages table, here are my messages. Now, to show you this is working in real time, I can actually show you this with two tabs. Here I have the same project open in two tabs. If I type a message in this window, it comes through in the other window. If I type a message in this window, you'll see it in the other window as well. So that's demoing the real-time functionality, updating the database in real time in Supabase. Make sure that when you want to use the real-time functionality that you turn real-time on the table that you need it. My messages table is here. That's what I was just demoing. And here is real-time on. And also set up your row level security policies as you usually would. For our messages table in this template demo, we've set the row level security policy to only be able to see and update your own messages that you insert into the database. If you want to see how the real-time messages are working inside the app, you can go into the dashboard component and have a look at the messages section. And this is using the super real-time component. The events on this component are on insert, on update, on delete. So every time something is inserted or updated or undeleted, these events will fire, these workflows will run, and everything is kind of dealt with for you by the Supabase Connect package. Just to demo the file upload for you, I'm just going to upload a file by dragging one into the drop zone component. There is my file, and I'm going to find it in the database. Now, in the storage area of our Supabase database, if you go to storage, we have a bucket called user files. And here is the file that I just uploaded. Nordcraft office hours, terrible thumbnail. My designer was on vacation. To configure file uploads when you're using this component from the Supabase Connect package, if we go in this template to the files section, the drop zone, and the super drop zone, you'll see on this super drop zone component that there are some attributes, and there is an attribute called upload path. And the value of this is user files, which is the same name as the bucket that I want my users to upload to in Supabase. So that's it. That's the new Supabase Connect package that you can use today in your projects. It's an unstyled component package ready for you to use Supabase straight away. But if you're curious about how to set it up, if maybe you're new to Supabase, new to Nordcraft, you can create a new project using the Nordbase template and learn how it's used, learn how it works, and start building Supabase into your projects. If you've got any questions about how to use the Supabase Connect package or the Nordbase template, come and join us in the Discord. We'd love to see you there. And I can't wait to see what you built with Nordcraft and Supabase.